Welcome back to the newsroom. The Lagos State Public Relations Officer, SP Benjamin Udain, has confirmed the 32 suspects have been arrested following a violent attack on a Ministry of Education team at the Federal College of Education in the Akoka area of the state. According to Udain, the team has been sent to mediate a three-month-long impasse between staff and the provost, who had been locked out of his office. However, the situation escalated when staff and students attacked the team, damaging over five vehicles and the provost's quarters. A former national chairman of the People's Democratic Party, PDP, Uche Secondus, has voiced his support for the planned End Bad Governance protest in Nigeria, while also challenging President Bola Tinubu's stance on the matter. Secondus, in a statement released on Tuesday by his media aide Ike Abonyi, reminded the president of his history with protest, saying President Tinubu, while in opposition, was a notable arrowhead leading protests against the government. Secondus emphasized the importance of peaceful protest in addressing Nigeria's current challenges. The Federal Capital Territory Minister Nyesom Wike said President Bola Tinubu has approved the establishment of a mandated secretariat for youth affairs in the nation's capital. Wike made the disclosure on Monday during an interactive engagement with stakeholders in the Buhari Council area. The FCT minister also called on the residents to shelve the planned nationwide protest scheduled for August 1st to 10, 2024. Telecommunications firm MTN has shut all its stores and services centers across Nigeria. This is coming on the heels of an outrage by some of its subscribers across the country after the network provider barred their lines on Sunday. MTN, however, directed its customers to use their digital channels for support during this period. A Competition and Consumer Protection Tribunal has granted the dismissal of a subscription price hike case instituted against MultiChoice Nigeria. A three-member tribunal led by Thomas Okosu gave the interim order following an other application by Festus Onifade, the claimant, to withdraw his case against MultiChoice. On April 29, 2024, the tribunal stopped MultiChoice from increasing its tariffs and cost of products and services, which was scheduled to begin on May 1, 2024. And on the foreign scene, landslides in India triggered by pounding monsoon winds has killed at least 45 people, with at least 250 others rescued from a landslide transformed by mud and debris, according to officials on Tuesday. The southern coastal state of Kerala has been battered by torrential downpours, with block roads into the disaster area at Wayanad district complicating relief efforts. And on sports, Super Eagles forward Kelechi Iheanacho will sign a two-year contract at La Liga club Sevilla this week. Iheanacho is expected in Spain on Tuesday to undergo his medicals. The versatile striker will join the former UEFA Europa League winners on a free transfer. And these are the stories making the rounds at the top of this hour from our newsroom. Join us at the top of the hour for more stories. I am Okpeyemi Owosheni. See you next time.